What's up, guys? Jay, we're Amberkill, and I'm back here on Destiny, live in a tower, and it's Friday, and we all know what Friday means on my motherfucking channel, right? That's right. It's time for another visit from Xur, the agent of the 90s, a rare NPC that shows up in a tower or the Queen's Reef once a week with a backpack filled of exotic gear and weaponry. You know this, man! Or at least you should by now. However, for the last 5 to 10 minutes, Mac had like the biggest brain fart in the world. I literally sat here wondering why the fuck my PlayStation wasn't working. I was like, why is Destiny not loading? That's because, Mac, you've had your PlayStation on for about 3 hours now and your controller is not illuminated. That means it is not turned on at the moment, which means you are actually trying to use a controller that is not turned on. And that's what happens when you make videos live at 5 o'clock in the morning on a motherfucking Friday. That's right, we got a man with a face full of dicks in an alleyway and a backpack filled of most likely Guardian's Tears and sadness, because if you've been playing for a while, you probably already have everything that he has to offer. Xur is here to play catch-up for a lot of people going into the Rise of Iron DLC that was revealed yesterday. So it's an exciting time in Destiny, even if his inventory is not going to be very excited for... Yeah, look, that's not very exciting, Xur. But we are moving into the Vigia game circuit of E3. Then we got the conventions like Gamescom and then PAX leading all into the release of the Rise of Iron. So it is a very exciting time in Destiny again when we get to see things that we haven't seen before. But speaking of things we've seen before, this is Xur's inventory for the week. Where is you guys out there? I like to be Titans. We got the Glass House, which will allow your Blessing of Light and Weapons of Light to last just a little bit longer. Oh, won't you stay? And we got Intellect and Strength on that roll. Not a bad piece of weaponry for those of you guys out there. It's a very versatile piece of weapon for you Titans, and it doesn't end up with me getting shoulder charged in the Crucible. So you know what? A little golf clap for you. Good job, Xur. You didn't bring anything that's gonna make me mad. However, this doesn't make me particularly happy is the occlusion of the Don't Touch Me Bros, which is like probably the best piece of gear for Crota's End. However, Crota's End isn't very viable at the moment for an activity. But yes, this will basically allow you to go invisible when you take melee damage. Now, it's not very useful inside of PvP. PvE, it saved me quite a few times during Crota, but I'm not quite sure exactly how good this would be for the King's Fall raid. I would honestly probably, if you're going to be Blade Dancing, you're probably going to want to use like a Tarantella or possibly the Mask of the Third Man. A lot of people like to run that. I really do enjoy both of those, but I don't Blade Dance very often, so you won't be seeing me use these very often. But if you need it for your collection, it's there. They're not going to go ahead and spit in the face of a gift horse, because there are probably newer players out there that are probably like, oh my god, yeah, I didn't have those. Go ahead and pick them up if you need them. And if you have the need to want to look like a motherfucker from the Slipknot, then go ahead and pick up the Ram. This will gain increased armor and all Voidwalker melee attacks trigger lifesteal on hit. See, this is the exact type of thing that you don't want to use in PvP, because it annoys old dear old Mac. But no, this is actually a pretty decent piece of equipment. I remember in year one, a lot of people were using these to survive thorns, because thorn was like a 2-shot to the head. This would make it at least like, I think it was like a 3-shot at the best. So the gained increased armor actually is very viable. And with the recent April update buff to the Voidwalkers in PvP, not a bad piece of gear. And it's got a good roll on it too. We got Discipline and Strength, which is exactly what you'd probably want for the PvP. Anyway, without having to use the dirty needles. What do we got on this one? All Strength, yeah. Not too bad. I guess, you know, it's a melee-centered piece of gear, so that's not too bad of a roll, even though it's not too useful these days. And we got the Red Death Year 2 version. This thing, I swear to God, man, every time I come across a Red Death inside of the Crucible, it's always because the motherfucker is healing from killing somebody right before me. And I'm like, oh, look, this guy has a little bit of health. Let's go ahead. No, because this will allow you to heal after each kill. And what's the word for that? Accelerated. That's the word I'm looking for. The recovery time with the Red Death after each kill is quite accelerated. You'll catch quite a few people off guard inside of Crucible. Mac had like a fucking another brain fart this morning. I'm sitting here trying to use a fucking controller. It's been turned off for 3 hours. And Mac's sitting here like, what is the word for increase in speed? Acceleration. There we go. 5 o'clock in the morning. Remember, live vigils, exactly what you get. But yes, that is a pulse rifle that will allow you to heal after each kill, and apparently it will speed up your reloads as well, which will gain you a little bit of extra survivability inside of the Crucible. You pair that with the RAM, you're probably good to go. You got lifesteal and melee triggers, so if that doesn't heal you up, then your lifesteal on your melees will, and you'll have a little bit of extra armor to survive some motherfuckers trying to close that gap on you. So, that looks like a pretty viable build right there for y'all warlocks out there in the PvP. It burns when I PvP, though. It really does. And for those of you guys that are actually trying to pick up some of your year one weapons for your kiosk collections, this is going to give you a year one special weapon, and I don't think we'll ever see Xur sell any exotic engrams. With the way that they changed the loot system, exotics will always give you light above your current level, so I don't think we'll ever see exotic weapon, exotic armor engrams inside of inventory, unless they change that system, because then you can just sit here and farm light with strange coins all day long. All day long. And we already mentioned the dirty needles, which will allow you to change the perks on the interior of your exotic. So, say you don't like any of these perks, you wanted to get maybe more discipline and more strength, because this is going to give you just a tiny bit of discipline or an ass load of strength, and you're like, you know, I would rather want a better split of that. You would go ahead, buy some dirty needles, exchange it for some clean ones, and then go ahead and twist the fate right here, and it will change all of your progress in here, and it will change all of your perks in here, and won't mess with your progress one bit, even if it's halfway leveled up, and it has a little bit of extra light on it. It won't affect your light or your progress in leveling. It will just change the interior alligator crocodile. Hell, you got the 3 of coins. Now, I know a lot of people are like, oh my god, you know, 3 of coins, blah, blah, blah. Possibly could have ruined the game in year 2 for a lot of people, since they were able to farm their exotics very easily, very reliably at the start of the Taken King. However, I feel like these might be getting removed from the game sometime before Rise of Iron. And if you're the type of people that like to have things inside your inventory that makes no sense to still hold on to, but the only reason you're holding on to it is because I don't have anything like that in my actual inventory, or like year one telemetries, you know, shit like that. I like to collect things that you can't buy in game anymore. So if you're that type of person, you might want to stick a couple of these inside the bank before the Rise of Iron hits later on this year, because I feel like these might be getting removed from the game. And then we have one of the biggest ripoffs in year 2, Destiny, because this used to give you 5 That's right. 5 heavy ammo for 1 strange coin. However, Xur felt that he needed to go ahead and change his prices for year 2. And it's now 3 heavy ammo for 1 strange coin. If you do have a plethora of strange coins on hand, go ahead and spend it on that purple drink. However, if you go out to the reef and talk to Varix, yes. You have a little bit of ether seeds, a little bit of that Glimmer, and he gives you the cheapest purple drink that you can get in game. Please. Please believe that. And we have the purple rarity upgrades for a blue rarity sparrow. Using one of these on a blue rarity sparrow will upgrade it to a legendary and will give it the color of the contrail as denoted by the player card showed on screen. So if we go here and we take a look at our sparrow, yes, this S30V used to be a blue rarity sparrow. We went ahead and upgraded it like 5 weeks ago. Finally, I get to show this damn thing off. And it leaves an unusual green trail because I used a green contrail. Contrail plasma drive upgrade. I used the emerald coil to follow the yellow brick road. But yes, you have a little bit of a different sparrow than everybody else. Because I know most people are rocking these basic bitch Sparrow Racing League ones. It's not as cool as the original Tumbler, though. Look at that, baby. I wish they'd allow us to level that up to match the speeds of those. But it is OG as fuck. I love my Tumbler from the dark below. So, my name is Jay. More than Afterkill, I want to thank you guys for watching. Make sure you guys rate, comment, subscribe. If you can leave a thumbs up on a video, I'd highly appreciate it because it gives me motivation to make more videos for you motherfuckers and watch my motherfucking videos. And finally, now that we got a lot of new things on the way in Destiny, a lot of new things to cover in Destiny, and some new things to be excited for in Destiny, you can expect to see more than just Xur and Banshee Vidges on my channel in the Derp Cities. And it feels good. It feels good to be excited for Destiny again. Especially since a lot of us have put a lot of time into this fucking game. And a lot of money. A lot of money as well. It's nice to see things not go wasted in life. It's like nobody left in the tower anymore. It's like, there's so many people here when I got here. I must have rambled on for like 10 minutes. And everybody's like, fuck this guy. I don't mind talking into my mic, am I? I did that on Overwatch one time after my stream was done. I ended my stream and I forgot to unplug the mic from my PS4. And fucking the dude was like, dude, I fucking hear you talking to everybody, man. You need to turn that goddamn mic off. And I was like, oh shit, that's right. Still fucking just fucking talking through the mic in game on Overwatch. And people were like, well, you got autism talking to yourself for the last half hour. They're like, oh no, it's live streaming. They're like, oh, all right. We just figured you were retarded. So, my name is Jay. We're an Afterkill. Thanks for watching. And I'm going to see you guys later.